Hello everyone, today we have new video review, and as you can see, this time we are going to check fresh release from Edward. It is part of Super 44 series, and it is modded in 144 scale. It copies MiG 51, actually 15Bs, not 51. And this is a fresh release. We have a commercial sample, so it means you will get exactly the same stuff as what you will see in this video review. As you can see, this kit comes in the new packaging, which was refreshed recently, so it means plastic back and cardboard inside, and we can see plastic sprues from the opposite side. But of course, we are going to open it and take a look inside in order to check everything closer. In the meantime, let me remind you that you can support us financially. It is quite easy thing to do because we have special donate button on our website, and of course you decide how much we will get for new photo and video equipment, or maybe for a new kit to be reviewed in our video review. So, okay, I removed everything out of this plastic bag. We are going to start with sprues, of course, and then we will continue with assembly manual. So just give me a second. This is funny small plastic bag, by the way. As you can guess, this is a original Edward plastic. It was released some time ago, so some of you might have even assembled it already, but this is a fresh release with new marking options as far as you can see. Well, some of them are repeated, but still it will be interesting to replicate them in 144 scale. So here we have first plastic port. Let's zoom in because otherwise you won't be able to see it. Here we have the canopy, which is molded as a one piece part, and it would be strange to expect something different from small scale kit. So, I mean, that's completely fine because we do not have a lot of detailing in the cockpit, and it's not such a huge issue, I would say. Here we go on with first gray plastic sprue. Let's zoom out a bit. So we have top fuselage half molded together with wings. This is quite unusual for aircraft kit, but in 144 scale, it is fine, I would say. And here we have lower half molded separately. Then we have engine nozzle here, and if you flip it over, here you can see that wing is molded as a single piece element, which is really cool, because you won't have any ugly seams in such visible area. Let's open lenses a bit so that you can see what we have here. Next we have second gray plastic sprue. This one carries mix of various parts. So here we have mainly exterior elements, but of course there are several cockpit elements as well, because for example here you can see cockpit floor or cockpit base. Also we have the pilot seat, and here you can see the tail fin. Here you can see the air nozzle separator. Here we have landing gear wheels, landing gear legs, fuel tanks and bombs. And let's flip it over. Here you can see that cockpit features pre-molded pilot seat. That's what I mean by describing the cockpit. And it might be preferable for some maneuvers because you won't have to deal with really tiny parts. Some maneuvers would want to see separate element. I'm not sure why, maybe for ease of painting, but it is not here and you have to deal with it. Next we go on with mask sheet and also decals. So that's really cool that Edward decided to include masks into their Super 44 kits. It means canopy is covered, and also we have here masks for wheels as far as you can see. So it's also quite handy addition. Next we go on with decals. These are printed in Edward, so printing quality looks really good. And we even have decals for the cockpit. So as you can see, we have seat belts, we have also anti-glare surfaces, and here we have instrument panel, which is quite simple, but 144 scale, what can you expect from this kit? Next we have assembly manual. So this one is printed in form of small brochure. It is color printed brochure. We have marking options on the first page, so there are four of them in this kit. And then straight away we go with assembly process. So everything starts with cockpit. As you can see, you have to attach this nose area separator, and cockpit here you have to apply decals and paint it. Then you assemble everything in fuselage, you assemble landing gear. Here you can see masks application guide, and then we continue with installation of landing gear on the aircraft canopy, and that's pretty much all as far as you can guess. Here we have external fuel tanks, so it's up to you whether you would like to have them on your aircraft or not. Here we have first marking option. This one comes from North Korea, May 1953. Next we continue with Egypt, early 1960s, late 50s. Then here we have Czech aircraft, which is quite familiar to some of you who were following the 172nd scale release. And here we have one more. This one comes from Soviet Union mid-50s. As you can see, it has quite interesting repainted aircraft number. So as I said before, this kit is already available on official Edward website. It might be interesting purchase in case you are tired from big scale builds. Then this one might be a good relaxed build. And of course, I will be happy to hear your opinion about this model here in the comment section below. If you like this video, don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And I will see you in the next video review as usual. Thank you for watching and bye.